भूवस्वितुर्वरेण्यम परो देवश्यधीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ शांति 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 शांति। नमस्ते माय डियर फ्रेंड, दिस इज वीडियो नंबर 23 ऑन टॉक्स विद श्री रामना महर्षि। वीडियो नंबर 23 स्टार्ट्स विद टॉक नंबर 381। मिस्टर बोस द बंगाली इंजीनियर आस्क्ड द मीनिंग ऑफ द लास्ट स्टेंजा ऑफ आत्मविद्या नॉलेज ऑफ द सेल्फ। श्री भगवान एक्सप्लेन्ड ऑन द फॉलोइंग लाइन्स। देर इज द वर्ल्ड परसीव्ड, द परसेप्शन इज ओनली अपरेंट, इट रिक्वायर्स लोकेशन फॉर एग्जिस्टेंस एंड लाइट। सच एग्जिस्टेंस एंड लाइट आर साइमल्टेनियस विद द राइज ऑफ माइंड। So the physical existence and illumination are part of mental existence and illumination. The latter is not absolute, for the mind rises and sinks. The mind has its substratum in the self, which is self-evident, that is, its existence and self-luminosity are obvious. That of absolute being continuous in sleep, waking and dream states also. The world consists of variety, which is the function of the mind. The mind shines by reflected light, that is light reflected from the self. Just as the picture in a cinema show are seen only in diffused, that is artificial light, but not in a strong glare or in thick darkness, so also the world pictures are perceptible only in diffused, that is reflected light of the self through the darkness of avidya, ignorance. The world cannot be seen either in pure ignorance as in sleep, or in pure light as in self-realization. Avidya is the cause of variety. The engineer said that he understood it only intellectually. Maharshi, because intellect holds you at present, that is, you are in the grip of intellect in the waking state when you discuss these matters. Later it was added that grace is needed for realization. The engineer asked how grace has to be got. Maharshi, grace is the self. It is not manifest because of ignorance prevailing. With Shraddha, it will become manifest. Shraddha, grace, light, spirit are all synonymous with the self. 5th April 1937, talk number 382. A Telugu gentleman, quiet in look but learned in philosophy, asked Sri Bhagwan about Manolaya. Sri Bhagwan said that everything is contained in Upadeshasram. A copy of which the man was holding in his hand. Devotee, what is mind? Maharshi, see what it is. Devotee, it is sankalpa, vikalpamaka, vipalmatmaka, made up of thoughts and their changes. Again, I repeat this. Devotee, ask the question. It is sankalpa, vikalpatmaka, made up of thoughts and their changes. Maharshi, whose sankalpa, thought? Devotee, sankalpa is the nature of the mind. Maharshi, of what is the sankalpa? Devotee, of the externalities. Maharshi, quiet, so is that your nature? Devotee, it is of the mind. Maharshi, what is your nature? Devotee, Sudha Chaitanya, pure conscious light. Mercy, then why do you worry about Sankalpa and the rest? Devotee, the mind is admitted to be changing and unsteady, Chanchala and Asthira. Maharshi, it is also said in the same place that the mind is to be introverted and made to merge into the self, that the practice must be long because it is slow and must be continued until it is totally merged in the self. Devotee, I want prasad, that is grace for it. Mercy, it is always with you. All that is required of you is not to confound yourself with the extrovert mind, but to abide as the self, that is prasad. The gentleman saluted and retired. Talk 383. Swami Lokeshananda, a sannyasi, asked Sri Bhagwan, is there prarabdha for Jivan Mukta? Maharshi, who is the questioner? From whom goes the question? Proceed. Is it a Jivan Mukta who is asking? Devotee, no, I am not a Mukta as yet. Maharshi, then why not let the Jivan Mukta ask the question for himself? Devotee, the doubt is for me. Maharshi, quite so. The Ajnani has a doubt but not a Jnani. Devotee, according to the creed that there is no creation, Ajatvada, the explanation of Sri Bhagwan are faultless, but are they admissible in the other schools? Maharshi, there are three methods of approach in Advaitavada. Number one, the Ajatvada is represented by no loss, no creation, no one bound, no sadhaka, no one desire of liberation, no liberation. This is the supreme truth. Mandukya Karika, chapter 2, stanza 32. According to this, there is only one and it admits of no discussion. Second, Drishti Srishti Vada is illustrated thus. Simultaneous creation. There are two friends sleeping side by side. One of them dreams that he goes to Banaras with his friend and returns. He tells his friend that both of them have been in Banaras. The other denies it. That statement is true from the standpoint of one and the denial from that of the other. Srishti Drishti Vada is a plan, gradual creation and knowledge of it. Karma is posited as past karma, etc. Prarabdha, Agami and Sanchita. There must be Kartritva, doership and Karta, doer for it. Karma action cannot be for the body because it is insentient. It is only so long as Deh Atma Buddhi, I am the body idea. Last, after transcending Deh Atma Buddhi, one becomes a Jnani. In the absence of that idea, Buddhi, there cannot be either Kartritva or Karta. So, a Jnani has no karma. That is his experience. Otherwise, he is not a Jnani. However, an Ajnani identifies the Jnani with his body, which the Jnani does not do. So the Ajnani finds the Jnani acting because his body is active, and therefore he asks if the Jnani is not affected by Prarabdha. The scriptures say that Jnana is the fire which burns away all karma. Sarva Karmani. Sarva all is interpreted in two ways. Number one, to include prarabdha. Number two, to exclude it. In the first way, if a man with three wives dies, it is asked, can two of them be called widows and the third not? All are widows. So it is with prarabdha, agami and sanchita. When there is no karta, none of them can hold out any longer. The second explanation is, however, given only to satisfy the enquirer. It is said that all karma is burnt away, leaving prarabdha alone. The body is said to continue in the functions for which it has taken its birth. That is prarabdha. But from the jnani's point of view, there is only the self which manifests in such variety. There is no body or karma apart from the self, so that the actions do not affect him. Devotee, is there no deyatma buddhi? I am the body idea for the jnani. If, for instance, Sri Bhagwan be beaten by an insect, is there no sensation? Maharshi, there is the sensation and there is also the deyatma buddhi. The latter is common to both jnani and ajnani, with this difference that the ajnani thinks deva atma, only the body is myself, whereas the jnani knows all is of the self. Atamyam sarvam or sarvam khalvidam brahma, all this is brahma. If there be pain, let it be. It is also part of the self. The self is purana, perfect. Now, with regard to the actions of the jnani, they are only so called because they are ineffective. Generally, the actions get embedded as sanskaras in the individual. That can be only so long as the mind is fertile, as in the case of the ajnani. With the jnani, the mind is surmised. He has already transcended the mind. Because of his apparent activity, the mind has to be inferred in his case, and that mind is not fertile like that of an ajnani. Hence, it is said that a jnani's mind is Brahma. Brahma is certainly no other than the jnani's mind. The vasanas cannot bear fruit in that soil. His mind is barren, free from vasanas, etc. However, since prarabdha was conceded in his case, vasanas also must be supposed to exist. If they exist, they are only for enjoyment, bhoga hetu. That is to say, actions bear twofold fruits. The one for enjoyment of their fruits, and the other leaving an impression on the mind in the form of sanskaras for subsequent manifestation in future births. The jnani's mind, being barren, cannot entertain seeds of karma. His vasanas simply exhaust themselves by activities ending in enjoyment only, bhoga hetu karma. In fact, his karma is only from the ajnani's standpoint. He remains actionless only. He is not aware of the body as being apart from the self. How can there be liberation, mukti, or bondage, bandha, for him? He is beyond both. He is not bound by karma, either now or ever. There is no jivan mukta or vidheha mukta according to him. Devotee, from all this it looks as if a jnani who has scorched all the vasanas is the best, and that he would remain inactive like a stock or stone. Mercy, no, not necessarily. Vasanas do not affect him. Is it not itself a vasana that one remains like a stock or stone? Sahaja is the state. Talk number 384. The conversation turned on vasanas. Sri Bhagwan said that good tendencies and bad ones, suvasana and kuvasana, are concomitant. The one cannot exist without the other. Maybe that the one class predominates. Good tendencies, suvasana, are cultivated and they must also be finally destroyed by jnana. A young parody was mentioned. Sri Bhagwan remarked that latent impressions of previous births, purav janma sanskaras, were strong in him. Devotee, how does it manifest the ability to sight well-known saints? Is it Vasana in the form of a seed only? Maharishi, yes. Predisposition, sanskara is acquired knowledge and kept in stock. It manifests under favorable circumstances. One with strong sanskara understands the thing when present to him much quicker than another with no sanskara or weak sanskara. Devotee, does it hold good with inventors also? Maharshi, there is nothing new under the sun. What we call inventions or discoveries are merely rediscoveries by competent men with strong sanskara in the direction under consideration. Devotee, is it so with Newton, Einstein, etc.? Maharshi, yes, certainly, but the sanskaras, however strong, will not manifest unless in a calm and still mind. It is within the experience of everyone that his attempts to rake up his memory fail, whereas something flashes in the mind when he is calm and quiet. Mental quiet is necessary even for remembrance of forgotten things. The so-called genius is one who worked hard in his past births and acquired knowledge and kept it in store as sanskara. He now concentrates his mind until it merges in the subject. In that stillness, the submerged ideas flash out. That requires favorable conditions also. 6th April 1937, talk number 385. Mr. Venkata Rao Anandra, gentleman, in the course of conversation with Sri Bhagwan, was told, until you gain jnana, you cannot understand the state of a jnani. There is no use asking about the work of Ishvara and the rest. Some ask why Shiva went naked in Dwarka forest and spoiled the chastity of the rishis' wives. The Puranas which record this incident have also said that Shiva had previously saved the Devas and the universe by consuming the poison of Halachala at the time of churning the ocean of milk. He who could save the world from the deadly poison and led the sages to emancipation had also wandered nude among us, their women. Their actions are incomprehensible to ordinary intellects. One must be a jnani to understand a jnani or Ishvara. Devotee, should we not learn the jnani's ways and imitate them? Maharshi, it is no use. Vasanas are of four kinds. Number one, pure Shuddha. Number two, impure Malina. Number three, mixed Madhya. And fourth, good Satya. According as the jnanis are the supreme virishta, the best varya, better vara, and good vitta. Their fruits are reaped in three ways. Number one, of our own will, svechha, and by others' will, pricha, and involuntarily, anicca. There have been jnanis like Gautama, Vyasa, Sukha, and Janaka. Devotee, was Vyasa also jnani? Maharshi, yes, certainly. Devotee, why then did the Bathi angels don clothes when he appeared before them, but not when Sukha passed? Maharshi, that same Vyasa sent Sukha to Janaka for instruction. Sukha was tested by Janaka, and finally he returned convinced of Vyasa's greatness. Devotee, is jnana the same as Arudha? Maharshi, so it is. Devotee, what is the relation between Bhakti and Jnana? Maharshi, eternal, unbroken, natural state is Jnana. Does it not imply love of self? Is it not Bhakti? Devotee, idol worship does not seem good. They worship the formless God in Islam. Maharshi, what is their conception of God? Devotee, as immanence, etc. Maharshi, Is it? Is not God even then endowed with attributes? Form is only one kind of attribute. One cannot worship God without some notions. Any bhavana premises a God with attributes saguna. Moreover, where is the use of discussing the form of formlessness of God? Find out if you have form, you can then understand God. Devotee, I admit I have no form. Maharshi, all right, you have no form in sleep, but in the waking state you identify yourself with a form. See which is your real state. That is understood to be without form on investigation. If you know yourself to be formless by your jnana, should you not concede the same amount of jnana to God and understand him to be formless? Devotee, but there is the world for God. Maharshi, how does the world appear? How are we? Knowing this, you know God. You will know if he is Shiva or Vishnu or any other all put together. Devotee, is Vaikuntha in Parampada, that is the transcendent self? Maharshi, where is Parampada or Vaikuntha unless in you? Devotee, Vaikuntha etc. appear involuntarily. Maharshi, does this world appear voluntarily? The questioner returned no answer. Maharshi, the self-evident I, ignoring the self, goes about seeking to know the non-self. How absurd! Devotee, this is Sankhya Yoga. Being the culmination of all kinds of other yogas, how can it be understood to start with? Is not bhakti antecedent to it? Maharshi, has not Sri Krishna started with Gita, with Sankhya? Devotee, yes, I understand it now. So I end this video here. Next video number 23 will start with talk number 386. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, comment and share the video and subscribe the channel. Thanks a lot. Namaskar, mere pyare dosto, my dear friends.